Hi guys, welcome to another range test video. This is the Byd Atto 3. In this video, I want to find out the range in real life driving conditions. I will test the range on the highway to find out the minimum range of this car. I will also do a second range test at lower average speeds to know the maximum range. I also wanted to know how long it takes to charge the battery at a fast charger. This is the Atto 3 with the 60.48 kilowatt hour battery. It has a WLTP range of up to 420 km. The Atto 3 has a power of 150 kilowatt or 204 horsepower. It goes from 0 to 100 kilometers per hour in 7.3 seconds. It has a maximum torque of 310 newton meter. I will first test the range at higher average speeds on the highway. I want to find out what the minimum range of this car could be. At the beginning of this part of the test, the battery is at 75%. I will base my estimated range based on the average consumption and the net capacity of the battery. I did the test in December and it was between 0 and -2 degrees. For the first part of the test, I drove from Brussels in direction to Namur for a drive of in total 60 km. The battery went down to 50%. And the estimated range based on a consumption of 22.4 kilowatt hour was 270 kilometer. I left the highway for some sporty driving on country roads. After that, the battery was down to 41%. And the estimated range increased a bit to 304 km. Now it's time to drive all the way back to Brussels on the highway. Let's have a look at my results. I emptied the battery down to 16% and the consumption increased again a bit during this drive. The range on the highway ended up to be 279 km based on an average consumption of 21.7 kilowatt hour. Later in this video, I will test the range at lower average speeds, but let's now do a charging test at a fast charger. The Byd Atto 3 is equipped with a combined charging system. This system enables the Atto 3 to be charged with both AC and DC. For this test, I will charge the car at a DC fast charger. The Atto 3 can fast charge at a speed of up to 88 kilowatt. Byd says it takes 29 minutes to recharge from 30% to 80% at a speed of 88 kilowatt. At the beginning of the test, the battery is at only 16%. It is 0 degrees outside. The car indicated that it would take around 57 minutes to fully charge the battery. I will do a 30 minute charging test. In the beginning, the car was charging at a speed of around 60 kilowatt. So while I'm waiting for the car to charge, I found this interesting activity to do. This video is sponsored by Encharge. Encharge is an app that lets you improve charging infrastructure through solving challenges. For this, you can earn kilometers. Kilometers have an equivalent value of 8 cents, and those kilometers you can exchange for free charging. The app is available in every European country. Let me show you how it works. There are two types of challenges, a high quality challenge and a photo charger challenge. Let's do first one of the high quality challenges. You can find those by clicking on the map icon and then you can filter on high quality challenge. The reward for doing such a challenge is 10 kilometers. Let's do the challenge. I need to answer some questions like how easy was it to access the charger, take a photo of the screen of the charger, and if that is damaged, show it on the photo. Take a picture of the parking lot, rate the cleanliness, rate the state of the CCS plug, rate the state of the screen, evaluate the cable holder system, etc. All done. I just earned 10 kilometers with the help of the community. Defects can be discovered and fixed faster. The charging infrastructure should become more reliable for everyone. Also, the results of your input go to, in this case, Ionity, and if a problem is reported, they are aware of the problem so they can fix it. So you can improve charging infrastructure by doing these challenges. Let's now do the charging station photo challenge. For this, I went to another location. I again click on the map. I click on all challenges. In this challenge, you have to take a picture of the charging station, the surroundings, the approach, and the parking lot. It's all very straightforward because you can see the example photos in the app. Another way of collecting kilometers is by online shopping. If you shop online at one of those shops and you go to the store via the affiliate links in the Encharge app, you get some free kilometers in the Encharge app. So what can you do with the kilometers you collect, you might wonder? This is the redeem section of the app. You can redeem kilometers for vouchers, for example, free charging at Electromaps and plug surfing. There is also this fun gamification aspect in the app called the EV League. When you do the challenges, you also collect EV enthusiasts points. The most active users advance to the highest league. The EV points can be exchanged for loot boxes. With those, you have a chance at winning things such as embroidery, frames or kilometers. If you want to try out the app yourself, I have a referral link in the description of this video. By using my link, you already get a starting credit of 20 kilometers, and I receive also a few kilometers as a thank you. Let's now get back to my charging test. After 10 minutes, I was charging at a speed of 55.8 kilowatt. The battery increased to 33% and we gained about 17% of battery charge. After 20 minutes, I noticed that we were charging at a speed of 59 kilowatt. I gained another 15% of battery charge and the battery is now at 48%. After 30 minutes, the battery is at 64%. The charging speed is still at 59 kilowatt. So we went from 16% to 64% in 30 minutes, or in short, you charge half the battery. I didn't do an AC charging test with this car, but let's look at some theoretical information. The charging speed of the onboard charger is 11 kilowatt. The AC charging time from 0% to 100% is 6.5 hours at 11 kilowatt. Let's now test the range at lower speeds in the city. I want to find out what the maximum range of this car could be. In the beginning of this part of the test, the battery is at 64%. Temperature was between 1 and 3 degrees. I did a test drive of 50 km, first in Brussels with lots of stop and go driving. After that, I left the city and I was driving on small town roads. It was in an urban area, sometimes a bit more in the country, but with lots of opportunity for continuous driving, mostly between 50 to 70 km per hour. Let's have a look at my results. I emptied the battery down to 52% after a test drive of in total 50 km. Average consumption ended up to be 14.6 kilowatt hour and the estimated range is 414 kilometer. In conclusion, I can say that the range of the BYD Atto 3 is somewhere between 279 kilometer and 414 kilometer based on similar driving conditions and measured at quite low temperatures between minus 2 and plus 3 degrees. I'm guessing that in much hotter temperatures, you'll probably get more range. With a battery of only 60 kilowatt, this car will not be the range champion on the highway, especially not in the winter. But for city driving, an average consumption of 14.6 kilowatt hour per 100 kilometer is actually quite good in the winter. Fast charging at a speed of 88 kilowatt is not best in class, but good enough. What I liked about this car was that it's quite luxurious and very well equipped. It feels premium, yes, even German premium, and this for a budget of 46,000 euros. On the inside, it's bigger than it looks on photos and probably also in this video. The parking camera is exceptionally good and I liked the ambient lighting. What I didn't like about this car was the wind noise at higher speeds. The range on the highway is not that great and fast charging could be a bit better. However, overall, I was pleasantly surprised by this car. It's maybe not that well known yet in Europe, but I would certainly take this car into consideration. If you want to try out the Encharge app yourself, I have a referral link in the description of this video. By using my link, you already get a starting credit of 20 kilometers, and I also receive a few kilometers as a thank you. I hope I was able to answer some questions you might have about this car. If you want to know more about the real world range of electric cars, there are also more videos on my channel and more to come in the future. Subscribe if you want to be notified about these future videos.